A sea of stones, blanketed with ice and snow. The Alps. Thousands of crags and peaks, soaring more than 3,000 meters high and stretching over 1,200 meters across Europe, fading into the clouds. The most beautiful stone formations in the world arise in the area between the Carvental and the Dolomites in Tyrol. In winter, the huge giants lie somberly underneath the weight of ice and snow. In the realm of the cold reigns the sound of silence. But it is interrupted. Above the timberline, the layers of snow break loose and roar their way down. Dragging with them anything in their way. Not only trees and boulders, but even animals fall prey to the avalanche. This chamois becomes the victim of nature. And now, biker. The golden eagle, flying powerfully through the air. Even if only a leg of the chamois is exposed through the snow, the sharp eyes of the king of the air has detected it. Now nourishment has arrived. With its razor-sharp beak, it opens the frozen fur. Avalanches often rescue golden eagles from starvation. In winter, nearly no prey can be found, and now the opportunity is taken advantage of. The lower regions are also under the strong hand of the icy winter. The forests brace themselves firmly against the heaviness of the snow crystals. Mountain streams and lakes sleep under the frozen blanket of ice. But what is underneath? How do the fish survive? We dive at night, under the full moon. It is February, and the spawning season. During winter, the water of the Alpine lakes has a temperature of 4 degrees Celsius. However, because water does not freeze at this temperature and is heavier than at colder temperatures, it builds up in the deep, a peculiarity which allows fish to survive the cover of ice. Therefore, way below the ice is an environment for living. The eels swim restlessly around, searching for a pebbled floor in order to deposit their eggs. In mud, the eggs will get too little oxygen. As the night gets later, more groups of fish come together to secure the next generation. Mating is in full force. A female ready to spawn is the center of action. Dozens of males fight for her attention, each one trying to be the one next to her when she spawns her eggs. Only then does a male have the chance to fertilize the eggs. The tiny eggs are filled with oxygen and rise slowly to the surface to mature in the flowing water. Where the streams are free of any ice, the rare dipper or water ouzel searches for food. It is a skilled diver and easily catches caddisfly larvae and the snails and crayfish in the water. Day after day, winter fades more and more. The sun warms the northern side of the Alps. Now, a very special, colorful bird is about. The wall creeper. Its long curved beak, its feathers, and its agility are reminiscent of a tropical hummingbird. The chamois now make their way down to the first blades of fresh grass. In winter, they prefer to wander through the higher regions, where the wind blows, an intelligent strategy for these hardy animals, as the blowing wind exposes remnants of vegetation from the snow, enough to enable survival. In order to surmount the enormous differences in height and geology, evolution equipped the chamois with remarkable muscle and hoof power. The hoofs are especially versatile. They can be used as climbing irons or as snowshoes. Also, the ravens feel the air of spring and the need to care for the next generation. Here, spring has arrived. Hungry, they stretch with their beaks poking out of the nest. But the mother raven makes them wait. Biker also makes it through the winter in good shape. On an unapproachable protruding rock, she prepares for her young, two eggs, on which she lays for 40 to 45 days. Enough food is very important, and it must always be sought. For this, the male is responsible, except when he occasionally takes over sitting on the eggs. As pairs, eagles make a good team and stay together for life. Spring finally arrives in the mountains. High up, the last of the snowfields surrender to the sun. Heather, crocuses, and primroses are the first messengers of spring in all their glory. The jackdaws fly low. And searched through the stale cow dung from last year for worms, a welcome meal after the sparseness of winter. The sun now heats the earth so strongly that not only can it be felt, but also seen. The groundhog also slowly awakens. And once again gets used to life outside of his hibernal home. The fresh meadows in the lower regions lure deer out from their security in the woods. They have missed the freshness of the green. Above them all circles Biker, the mother eagle. She searches for her prey in the early hours of the morning. This blackcock would be a very welcome meal, but the distance is too great, and she must return to sit on the nest. Meanwhile, the blackcocks and wood grouses begin mating in the morning hours. In the valley, the last remnant of avalanches disappear. The melting snow is in full force. The glacier water, still like white milk, transports vast quantities of gravel to the valley. This causes continuous changes throughout the mountainous landscape. The water rushes together in torrents and takes with it many layers of minerals as it flows its long way to the valley. Clean water, yet enriched with sediment, which provides a colorful show. Here in the Karwendel, the Isar is a clear turquoise, like glass, as it flows through the Hintertal Valley. Mountain lakes like the Riffelsee, 2,000 meters up, still show milky waters. This is due to the numerous glaciers. However, because of the effects of global warming, many of the glaciers are receding. According to some estimates, they will be entirely gone in 100 years. Because of the present condition, the sea level is indeed on the rise. In 1905, the Pasterze on the Großglockner reached to just below the Glockner house. Today, the Pasterze is almost completely melted, a cake of ice, 5 kilometers long and 200 meters thick, has disappeared since then. The effects of the vanishing glaciers in the Alps cannot be completely evaluated yet. It is now the beginning of May. High up in the eagle's nest, something begins to happen. An egg begins to crack. The young eagle, through much effort, slowly makes its way into the world. Its parents are tense. The birth requires much power and will last more than 50 hours. Each parent takes it in turn to watch over the nest and the surrounding area. The chick struggles to get out. The other egg in the nest, laid 3 to 5 days after the first one, is a kind of reserve egg. Often the youngest chick becomes a victim of fratricide. Only when there is enough food do both eagles fly from the nest. The eagle begins its life on the Arlberg. After a few hours, its eyes begin to open. Now, his first feathers are visible. But after his sixth day of life, the second layer of down is already growing, white and very thick. The young eagle is curious and investigates his surroundings. At around the 15th day of life, the chick spends most of its time caring for its own feathers. And the rest is spent eating and sleeping. The chick has an instinct to keep its nest clean, and therefore drops its excrement over the edge. To get rid of the irritating flies and to strengthen the relationship with its partner, Biker brings a fresh larch branch with its distinctive aroma to the nest. This is a sign to an observer that the nest is indeed occupied. Heavy equipment, intensive walking, long stays in uncomfortable camouflage tents, and special lenses were the price of admission to experience the world of the King of the Air. Only when they feel undisturbed can their natural behavior be observed. Feeding time. The male eagle, which is a third smaller than the female, flies to higher hunting areas in order to satisfy the chick's ever-growing appetite. The nest of the golden eagles is positioned at a lower point, making approaches easy and therefore energy saving as well. On the high pastures of the Alps are the tender morsels of the eagles. The marmots, or groundhogs. Once, these animals lived on the cold grasslands of Asia. But obviously, they are just as comfortable here as they are beyond the timber lines. Groundhogs are very cautious animals and watch closely everything around them as they leave their burrows. As an animal which is active during the day, it cannot be off guard. But this also means its alertness leads it to the finest foods around. Only the best alpine herbs are on the menu. Perhaps this is why oil made from the groundhog is used for human health benefits and pain relief. Large reserves of fat are important for these animals so that they can withstand the long hibernation period from mid-October until April. They live off of their fat. Groundhogs love to play around. But they never stop being attentive, not for a moment, even while prancing and playing, because their worst enemy is the golden eagle. A shrill cry warns the troop. Each one immediately seeks its burrow. It is only the young ones who don't understand what all the fuss is for, which is why they can be easy prey for the eagle. But today, the cry was loud enough. Above the pasture, we discover another eagle nest. In this one, two chicks are visible. Quite a rare sight in recent years. While natural selection mostly allows one chick to survive to adulthood, this time there seems to be enough food available for two to be raised. Now, fresh meat arrives. But here is where the sibling rivalry begins. And the adults do not intervene. They allow nature to take its course. The old bird viciously attacks the younger one. The fight lasts for a few hours. The parents still keep away. But this time, the weaker bird won't be pushed out of the nest. It can survive. The threatened owl takes care of its chicks. It is almost impossible to film the bird in the wilderness, as it is a nighttime hunter. Early in the morning, a pair of owls kill a raven. The mother flies to its nest with the heavy prey, awaited impatiently by the hungry chick. The meal lasts for more than an hour. Owls are perfect nighttime hunters. Ducks, hares, rats, and especially hedgehogs and other smaller animals are featured on the menu. That they also fight with ravens was not known until recently. The male owl often leads the raven astray in order to divert its anger. The summer, meanwhile, has made its appearance in the mountains. The rocky giants of the Alps are now covered with high, fresh, and succulent grass. Where now many alpine lovers tread, at one time was only water. Years earlier, the powers of the inner world pushed the Alps out of the flood. At that time, little by little, today's continents were formed. The Alps were formed due to the African plate coming under the European one. The Earth's crust was laid in folds. The Tethys Sea disappeared. Out of the volcanic minerals and sediment came these mountains. In the short days of summer, the high pastures become plush carpets for flowers. This brief, rich time is crowned by the blooming of the alpine rose. Who can believe that such beautiful heather exists? And who can believe that a kind of rhododendron is growing in the Alps as well? Beside the red carpets shines the deep blue gentian and the green of the pastures. In all its color, these flowers attract pollinators. Their protection must be secured. The wonderful Turk's cap lily appeared here upon migrating from Asia. As did the Queen of the Alps, the Edelweiss. It is always astonishing to see what splendor appears on naked stone. And now, the beautiful day comes to an abrupt end. Clouds and fog are coming. And the mountain winds blow. Within just a few hours, the temperature drops by 20 degrees. An outburst of winter follows. But for the sturdy inhabitants of the Alps, this is no problem. They're used to this. But the messengers of autumn must nevertheless make their appearance. It is late summer, and the days become clearly shorter. The high pastures are still green and offer enough food for the ibex. They eat now barely without a break. They must gain enough fat for the winter. It could be a hard one. And despite this, even now, in the autumn, hints of spring can be detected. It is necessary to get into position early. The first show fights of the mating season are taking place. The young bucks jostle and play with each other to demonstrate their skills. In the evening, they climb to their real home, the high mountains, without forgetting to show just who is the best. And higher up, in the rocks, Biker waits for its second chick to take its maiden flight. We wait for days as well. A sign pulls us out of the lethargy of waiting. The mother begins her flying animation. She demonstrates her flying skills and sails upward in the wind along the rocky wall. The flapping of the young eagle's wings is already strong enough to allow it to fly. But he is still afraid of falling. Now, Biker has a trick in store for the young one. With full power, she kills a chamois kid and flies with it past the nest. The young bird had almost no food during the difficult training time. He is very hungry, and now has to watch a tasty treat flying by. The young eagle cannot tolerate the temptation any longer. He He wants nothing else but food. But the mother lays down the chamois kid nearly 100 meters away from the young bird. Her little eagle must fly. Its first landing is a bit rough. But before long, his instinct will kick in and teach him to learn the flying technique from his mother. The well-chosen site and quality of the eagle nests prove invaluable, because the golden eagles have chicks at best every 2 years. A completely installed home is available for others as well. It is used by a family of falcons in the interim. Emptied eagle nests are also research areas for our biologist, Andreas Meyerhofer.
Jetzt schreit er wieder da draußen. Da gegen die Weiber brennt links gegen Innsbruck, also südöstlich.
Demonstrating his agility, he masters the extreme heights to reach the nest. Now it can be seen just how big the nest is. Thousands of flights were necessary to build this paradise. Andreas collects all that he can find. The findings could provide explanations about the feeding and living habits of the proud birds. He presents his findings in front of the mountain hut.
So, etwas von interessantesten war in dem Horst ein Habicht. Wie gesagt, wir haben sehr viele Federn gefunden von diesem Greifvogel, der vom Adler wahrscheinlich geschlagen wurde. Dann geht es weiter mit einem Unterkiefer, höchstwahrscheinlich von einem Eichhörnchen, Beckenknochen von einem Kleinsäuger, dann Rückenwirbel von einem Gams oder Schaf. Weiters haben wir Nachweise von einer Schafwolle, er dürfte auch einmal ein Hauslamm geschlagen haben. Dann weiters.
No doubt the eagle family had enough food. Meanwhile, autumn has painted its colors on the Alps. A melancholic silence embraces the forests and lakes. Baika will still be together with her son, and she will likely teach him many things. At an alm hut, children lost their little rabbit, and it enjoys its freedom. But it has already been spotted by the golden eagle. Without a sound, it lifts its wings to plunge down on its victim. At first, it seemed as if the little rabbit would escape. But then it happens. Claws as sharp as a knife stab the victim. Proudly, the young eagle snags its prey. Death came to the rabbit quickly and painlessly. The method was taught to the young eagle by its mother. She knows that soon her young one will have to face the rough life between these grand rocks. A helpless chick turned into a fine golden eagle over the past 6 months. The mentoring is over, and Biker knows that separation is near. Her son must find his own hunting territory. And she also knows that they will never meet each other again. This is a rule of life for the golden eagle. At the beginning of the 20th century, the golden eagle was nearly extinct. The spread of bad tales and stories legitimized the efforts of hunters and trophy collectors. The bird was said to have stolen children and murdered sheep. Such stories were enough to fuel the rapid extermination of the birds. Fortunately, information campaigns brought about change. Today, the biggest bird of prey in the Alps is protected, and its population has grown with the change of the seasons. Alone in the Bavarian Karwendel and northern Tyrol, 150 golden eagles exist. Here they can circle the skies again, in one of the last paradises of the world, the Alps.